Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of our show.
We're glad that you're watching. Thank you so much. We really appreciate it. We're going to try to give you something that is of value to you and, in particular, the young people in your home. Maybe you are a young person. I want to talk about kids and stuff. Now, when you were a little girl, which was, to me, 5 minutes ago, what do you remember that was valuable and fun in the area of creativity that we as parents got right?
I mean, you guys always really push creativity with me.
Now, what does that mean, push creativity? Like, so, you know, get in your room and you're going to do 10 drawings in there.
I guess you encouraged me to create things. There would be times where I wanted to watch TV or something and you're like, why don't you just draw something instead? I really value it now because I realize how much drawing and stuff I did do as a kid, which I think is awesome. And it was always really fun. And doing that, it kind of takes you away to another place. I encourage drawing.
What's so great about drawing? Because I like to draw and I always enjoyed it when I was a kid. And I there was something, I don't know, innately fun about it. I don't know. It sort of took ideas out of my head and onto paper. And even though I was really crappy at it for, you know, the first 10 years, it rewarded me enough for some reason. But what is that, do you think?
I don't know. I mean, you're just like making something. It doesn't even matter how it turns out, really. And you can just do it and it's right now, right there.
Mm-hmm. And people can look at it and they can admire it or not.
You have something to show somebody. I did this.
Yeah. That raises something I definitely understand, which is that it's a kind of a having thing. It's a way to have something.
Mm-hmm.
You'll see, like I remember growing up with boys. When I was a kid, if there was anybody else that drew, there were very few people that drew really habitually. They were all into sports or whatever. We had no games. So we had no video games.
Yeah.
People would do sports or they, I don't know what, it was skateboard, you know. But the guys, the few guys that drew were different from me because they would draw specific things that they liked that were not the things that I liked. They would draw cars or they would draw weapons and stuff like that. Machines, robots and stuff like that, which I had no interest in. And I think that it's a step towards having those things.
Yeah, totally.
Because the things that I drew, I eventually kind of wound up with too. I drew weird people and characters and funny things because I don't know, I wanted to experience them. And now as an impressionist, I kind of do. I'd make up characters. And I love being in someplace like New York where you walk down the street and the people that I was trying to draw are all walking on the street.
Yeah, another thing too that I would say that you guys did right as parents too is you never criticized my art or the things that I made, and you were very supportive of it, and you didn't even, you know, give me suggestions about it. You just kind of let me freely create. It's not like everything that someone's kid makes is going to be the best thing in the world maybe, but I think that's really important what you guys did with giving me that safe space to create.
Wow, nice. I'm glad we got that right. We were trying to get that right. We knew that that was the right thing to do, but sometimes you can't control yourself. You know, I'm sure a lot of people watching this have watched another person do a painting or a haircut or build something or a jigsaw puzzle even and go, you know, if you would just, could I just help you? Could I, you know, and they can't quite hold themselves back from the evaluation of, you know, we did the right thing. Check it out. If you're a parent, try to withhold, I guess, yourself from giving so much advice on artistic creation to your child. Let them create because they're working something out. They're building towards a future, maybe. They're coming up with some image that they have. Maybe it's an idea. It's a tiny, little, delicate idea. And just anything can blow it away and destroy it or stunt it. And if you yourself as a creative person feel any kind of impulse to do something, to create something, just do it, you know, give it a try, give it a shot. You're always going to learn something from the creative process, don't you find?
Definitely.
And if you're a kid, go ahead and draw it. You know, go ahead and draw and paint or write a song or come up with something. It's good for you. It's healthy. You may not make any money, but you're going to be able to experience something and learn something. And it's actually healthy for you.
It feels good.
Unless someone comes along and says, why'd you use a brown crayon? I use pink crayon. That's terrible.
Yeah.
All right. I hope that's helpful. And please leave a comment below, subscribe and all that stuff. We appreciate you. Thank you for watching.
Have a great day.
Arrivederci.